Welcome back to The Witcher 3. The last thing we did was defeat the grave hag that was plaguing this village. Now, I do want to get back to doing the main quest. However, before that, one of the other quests I picked up here at this village, on top of the grave hag quest, was the one from that crying old woman who wanted me to clear out the monsters that had taken refuge in her old manor. So I'm gonna go do that. I wanna go help that woman out, because at the moment she doesn't have a roof, even over her head. She doesn't have anywhere to stay. So, kinda time sensitive. I wanna give her a place to live. So let's go do that. It's kinda far away, but there's a bunch of interesting question marks to hit along the way. Let's go for this one first. Come on, Roach. Off to adventure. And beyond.
Let's go!
What's beyond adventure? More adventure? Oh wait, this is not the way to go, is it? No. Actually, is this the way to go either? This leads up to the grave. Yeah, this should work. Question mark over there. Not a question mark. Oh wait, there's a question mark. Oh wait, and this was a question mark, wasn't it? Wow, okay, so I wanted to go to this question mark and I accidentally ended up going to the other question marks. Alright, whatever. Question mark's a question mark. What's here? Looks like humies. Meat bags. Putrescent flesh sacks. Do I have any oils that are good for just general people? Cursed beasts? Well, they are disgusting. Do they count as a beast? Eh, probably not. Do I actually have a recipe for a... Oh my god, what is with this pinning formulas? Fine, pin this. Go away. It must be bugged or something. I don't know why I keep showing that. Ah, here we go. Hanged Man's Venom. So yeah, that's the general poison. But I'm missing Arenaria. Alright, let's throw some poison in their faces. I don't think I threw that very well. There we go. Much better. Okay, that's a lot of them. Way too many. Come on, spread out a bit. Ooh. Nice attack, man.
Fucking
try again.
Shit.
Nope. If you clear it out, they will come. Without being called, because the villagers have a psychic sense of when an area has been liberated. Jesus. Bless you.
My fortune traitors we find
this. This guy's like, his arm is like burning in the fire. I better put that out. Yeah, there's a million things to loot here, but whatever. I'm tired of looting.
making me sleepy.
Anyway, are you a herbalist?
What?
What?
Got anything interesting?
You have any arenaria? Alright, yeah, let's buy what I need, because I'm seriously missing some seriously key alchemical ingredients. And in fact, I think that's the arenaria right there. There it is. 5 crowns a pop, huh? Not bad. How many do I need? I think I just needed 4, but I might need it for some other things, too. I'll just buy 4 for now. Yeah, oh sweet, you can actually switch between alchemy and the shop, so I don't need to, like, leave the dialogue to be able to make stuff. That's cool. Yeah, so here we go. Hanged Man's Venom. Let's make that. Okay, I need some more for Spectre Oil, so 3 more. There we go. Yeah, I've got a really nice collection of oils. Got something for almost everything, I think. So for Insectoid, I need 1 more Ranigrin. Okay, yeah, now I've got a really nice collection of oils. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I've already got every single one of those potions made. I need to look into decoctions soon to see whether I want to make anything like that. I should also try to make... I should also try to make more bombs. Yeah, what do I need for these? Calcium equum. And phosphorus. Do you sell any of that stuff? Hmm, there's phosphorus. I think I just needed 1. And there's calcium equium, although it's pretty damn expensive. Hmm. You know, I bet I have something... I probably have something in my inventory right now that can be broken down into calcium equium, or perhaps crafted up into calcium equium. What do you bet? It seems implausible that I wouldn't have any of it, given all the stuff I've looted, you know? But anyway, let's make Dragon's Dream. It is fire damage. Nice. So how does that compare to poison? Plus 100 poison damage, plus 300 fire damage. Well, it sounds like Dragon's Dream is just more powerful. Obviously, some things are more susceptible to fire compared to poison, so... yeah, depends on the enemy, but the base damage seems a lot higher. And the effect is even longer, it's 15 seconds instead of the 10 seconds. Hm. Alright, cool.
Farewell.
Okay, next.
Giddy up.
Looks like a bunch of assholes. Yep, that's a bunch of assholes. I know what assholes look like, I've seen a lot of them in my time. So let's put on the Hangman's Venom. Let's put in the Dragon's Dream, too. Whoops. Please put that back in. Crap, which sword was that? This one? Well, whatever sword it was, it had poison on it. Yeah, it's that one. Okay. Alright, Gwen. Dragon's Dream. It's gonna get fiery up in here.
There's one! Instead of grabbing your gun, fight! Fortimeria!
Hmm. Didn't quite do what I thought it would do.
Witchcraft!
I didn't mean to dodge directly into the arrow.
It's
oh god. Run! It's gonna blow. Yep. That definitely blew. Poor guy screaming. I'm just gonna hide down here. You know what? Fuck you. Burn. I shot too high. Fuck me. I'm gonna burn in this cloud of burningness. I don't even care.
Bad
I'm doing
idea.
Terribly. Wow. That guy didn't care about the fire at all. Alright, stop shooting arrows at me, please. This is a very awkward place to fight. Oh, okay. I handled that really poorly. Ooh. Scoia-tail sword, bunch of blunt crossbow bolts, and a new crossbow. Wonder if I can use it. Yeah, some really nice crafting ingredients there. Got tons and tons of blunts. Alright, so let me see if I can use a new crossbow. Level 10. Level 7. Nope. Dang. Alright, what about the crossbow bolts? So those are the tracking bolts that I picked up last episode. Got blunt and... okay, two types of blunt. What's the difference? This one does more damage. Yeah, it's a level 1 bolt and it's a level 4. Compared to my current ones, which do very, very little, that is pretty good. Yeah, let's go ahead and use them. Still seems like it does such little damage, though. I don't think it's really going to be a significant amount. But it's something. Oh, wait a minute. Was there something else I wanted to check? Oh, I think it was the new crafting recipe. Yeah, I want to check out that Scoia-tail sword. Yes, pinning. Thank you. Oh my god, it's going to say that every single time, isn't it? Ooh, Assassin's Boots are way better than what I have right now. Oh, but it's required level 10. Never mind. Blah, 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 blah. Scoia-tail sword. Missing a dark steel ingot. Well, it can't be too hard to get. Oh, it's required level 27. Alright, forget that. Alright, let's set up this question mark and then go to the manor. Oh, oh.
Come on, Roach.
Can I go around? Just jump down. You'll be fine, Roach. Don't worry. Okay. I think the best thing to do here is probably just jump up here on my own and then call Roach. There we go. Actually, I'm already so close, I might as well just keep running. What have we got here? Bear. Time for some beast oil. Let's Quinn. And Thunderbolt. Level 12, oh my god. Alright, here we go. Jesus, that was fast. Come on, Quinn, come back. This thing's moving all over the place. Hold on, let me try my new bolts. That didn't do crap. Oh, Jesus. I need to take another Thunderbolt. Here we go. This thing really likes to move. Go ahead and heal up. I'm gonna swallow. That was close. One more Thunderbolt. Starting to get a lot of toxicity, but I'm okay. After all, I've taken abilities specifically for toxicity. Almost there. One more. One more. Oh. Okay. Wow. I think I did really, really good there. That was an enemy, what, twice my level? Yeah, I was level 12, I'm level 6. And it did a lot of damage every hit. I felt downright elegant there. Deftly dancing around the bear. Tracker's boots. I think I've already found those before. Yeah, all that and there's like barely anything here. Let me check the boots. Which tracker's boots did I find? These or the other ones? I guess it doesn't matter. Both of them are worse than what I'm wearing. Okay, manor time. Actually, sleep time. I need to regenerate my stuff. Onwards, Roach.
What now, you piece of filth?
What now is that I keep going? Oh, hello. Okay, let's get a little distance. You know, I knew there were beasts around here, but I thought they were inside the manor, not outside the manor, too. Alright, so that was a wraith. So, let's put on some wraithy oil. Well, it's Spectre oil, isn't it? Or is it cursed? Are wraiths cursed specters or cursed ones? Let's check. Cursed ones are werewolves, basically. Okay, so it's gotta be a specter. And, oh yeah, also, since I'm finding specters, I should probably put on the other kind of bomb, Moondust. Let's replace my blinding attack with Moondust. So we got Moondust and we've got Dragon's Dream.
Must be the manor the old woman mentioned.
Come on, fight me. Where did the other one go? Dang, no wonder she wants to move back here. Look at this place. Well, it's not just one place, it's a whole collection of places. And she would... Once I clear this, she's gonna have this entire place to herself. Hey, wait a minute. There's smoke coming out of the chimney. That means somebody must live here, right? Like somebody's here right now, or was just here. Come back here. Wait, return to Dolores. Are you serious? That was it? That's it? That was nothing. I was expecting so much more. Well, before I return, let's check out these buildings and see what there is to loot. Aw. Yeah, because she gave me the key to this place, right? key required. Oh, I thought she gave me the key. I guess I have to go back to her, and then she's probably gonna show me the family treasure that she promised me or something. Oh. I can go in here. Got a tactical roll our way out of there, of course. I just looted a ladle. Yay! Oh, hello.
Look like twins. Old woman's brother. Must be.
Okay, this is where there's smoke coming out of the chimney. Wait, what? Oh my god. Wow, this is the first, like, blatant, level design error that I've ever seen. Wow. I'm really surprised to see that, because the attention to detail in this game is so incredibly fine. Like, overall, but this chimney, it doesn't connect to anything. Like, for one, it doesn't seem to make any sense that it's even smoking. Because there shouldn't be anybody who actually lives here. But even if that was, like, a story thing, you know, somebody's been squatting in this place or whatever, it doesn't actually even belong there. There's a chimney, but if you go inside, it doesn't connect to anything. And you can see, like, a little bit of the bottom of the chimney sticking through the roof. They just placed it there and didn't connect it. My immersion. Sturdy barn key.
Wonder what door this opens.
Oh, wait a minute. This is highlighted as red. Didn't I just try to knock this down with art? What? I totally just used art on this. Weird. Gnomish prankings.
A journal. Little wear and tear. Someone's journal.
I wonder if there's more to Dolores than first met the eye. Maybe she's not just a poor woman who lost her home. Maybe something's wrong. I'm gonna read that in just a minute. There we go. Using
somebody lived here once. Dolores. Something here. A chest.
Why did that just like float out? There we go. So there's her family fortunes. Or her secret savings or whatever. Which I'm not stealing, she did say I should have them. Okay, that's it for this place. Well, let's read the journal. The third of Fayen, or something like that. Hot summer days have come earlier than usual this year. Humbert has grown unbearable. He gets angry whenever I accompany the milkmaids to the river. He says I'm not to fraternize with the help. What makes him truly furious is when I converse with Jan and Fred. He claims a well-born lady should not mix with men of lower rank, and that doing so undermines his rightful authority over them. Perhaps once the summer swelter begins to fade, he'll become more tolerable. The 20th. The boredom weighs heavier and heavier upon me. I love my brother, and I'm glad we did not sell the estate after our parents died. But at times, I daydream of what it would be like to live somewhere else, with other people. I'm just taking off my hoodie while I'm reading this, by the way. It's getting hot in here. There we go. The 43rd. We've a guest. He's the son of a lord from somewhere near Gors Velen. A hunt took him across our land, and he asked for lodging. Oh, what joy. Finally, something is happening. 15th of Lammas. The time has come to admit it. I love Roderick, and I feel he loves me too. I hope Humbert will be pleased. The 18th. I told Humbert about Roderick and me. He flew into a rage. He said that match was out of the question. Perhaps I can convince him otherwise. 21st. Humbert remains I don't remember how to pronounce that word. But I shan't abandon the love of my life for him. If I'm left with no other choice, I will run away with Roderick. Okay, so nothing surprising there. That seems to match up exactly with what she said. She ran away with Roderick, which wasn't an approved of relation, and when she came back, everybody was gone, I think. And it was just filled with wraiths. What a bad thing to come back to. Alright, let's check out gnomish prankings. Scrub the greasings from a dog's ear. Soak into cotton twine. Place in a new lamp of greenish hue. And set said lamp betwixt an eager crowd. Forsooth shall they swear that a dog's head they behold. And this shall be no sorcery. But good be tidings. For the Prince of Elender's nuptials, a paltry gnome armed with a miniature cutlass behid himself in a pie. When guests partook of the princely banquet, Annan jumped out of the besabred gnome, giving a terrible fright to all at first, then causing much merriment once the jest was figured. A cynocephalus, or a doghead, in our tongue, a beast that in the wastes of Zangabar dwells, has the corpus of a man but the head of a dog. The Prince of Elender did receive such a specimen from those far-off lands. The cynocephalus lets stream its urine with the tolling of every hour, both day and night, and this is why the Zangabarians engrave its likeness on timepieces and compasses. I have no idea what I just read. I read it, but it didn't, like, none of it meant anything to me. Alright, let's go back to Dolores. I think I missed a tiny building back there that looked like an outhouse, but... you know, it looks like an outhouse, so screw what the... what is that? That sounded like a dragon. Seriously, what is that? Level 20, huh? Ooh! Level 20. Can I take on a level 20 as a level 6? That is incredibly highly implausible. To the point where I'm gonna try. Bring it on. You have a lot of hit points. I could take you, eventually. It's like a thunderbolt. And now a wolf joined? Okay, you know what? I'm leaving. Goodbye. Come on, wolf. Wow, I just punched a wolf to death. Roach, follow me! Roach! Roach! Neckies.
Where'd you come from?
You've returned. What's become of my home?
It's safe now.
I thank you. This means so much. And perchance, did you find my chest? With my treasures?
Yeah, pretty generous as rewards go.
You've earned every last bit.
Time I was on my way.
Gods guide you.
I wish you the best, Dolores.
Baron Schmarin, what would it pass?
I've got to be close to leveling at this point, right? Yeah, 980 out of 1,000. Okay, you know what? I need
That's
to level
it,
up
Roach.
Before the end of this episode. Let's go find a question mark and let's go slice some dudes or some monsters or something. Oh, I'm supposed to find the Peller's Hut. It's part of the main quest, but also something else I have to do as for the main quest is down here too. I guess I could go to the Peller's Hut. But let's go to this question mark first. Because it's very, very close.
Glorian's still unwell.
See, so you're a man well traveled.
Come on, Roach. You can do better than that. Let's lube up. Alright, come on, bow dude. Just try to shoot me with an arrow. I'm gonna dodge it. Come on. Aw, damn it, I didn't. Do some more damage against this guy. Just took a thunderbolt. There we go. Level up. No! 993. Oh. Didn't mean to go up, but I guess I will. It looks like they murdered whoever was taking watch here. Dancing Star? That sounds like a bomb. Hey, come back here, Roach! What are you doing? Alright, just a little bit more combat and I'll level up. Guarded treasure. Let's go to the guarded treasure. Probably drowners. It's on the beach. New marker. Whoa. Person's in distress. Oh, wait. Wait. Somebody needs help. Roach! Oh, fuck it. Just get off. Somebody needs help. Somebody needs help. Oh my god! Woo! Hold on. Oh my god, they're doing so much damage! Stop running at me! Oh, stop shooting arrows at me. I need to separate them. If I'm gonna have any chance at all, I need to separate them right now. I can't take them all on. Jesus. Oh my god. There's too many arrows, I can't... What do I do? There's no way. There's no way. Where did I go? I went the wrong way. I was following... What was I even following? I shouldn't even be here. I meant to go there. I'm swimming. Goodbye. Maybe I'll just stay under the water. They can't shoot me under the water, right? Uh-oh. Drowners. Surface. I'm faster on the surface. Alright, let's rest for a little bit. Let's go the right way this time. I don't know what I was following. Oh, it's you. It would make a pretty awesome way to level up, wouldn't it, fighting that thing? What are you? Draconid? Cockatrice? Is that a cockatrice? I'm not quite sure what that is. But it's... I'm pretty sure it's a Draconid. Do I have Draconid oil? I don't. Yeah, I don't. And using fire against it's probably not gonna work, so I should probably switch that out. Yeah, let's get back the poison. Poison and stun. Yeah, I've done like 2% damage to it. Nope. 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 We're gonna go fight some drowners to level. It's not as cool, but at least I won't die. Dang it. There we go. Okay, So I've got 1 point. I still don't have another slot, and I'm not gonna have another one until I get one more level. I can put another point into brewing, which is probably what I'm gonna do. Yeah, let's do that. Let's put one more into brewing. Unless I want to save my points for something else. Nah, let's max this thing out. There we go. Maximum brewing and maximum poison. Well, maximum heightened tolerance and maximum poison blades, to be exact. There's a bunch of other skills that are related to poisons. Yeah, this entire line here is all about oil. This entire line here is all about brewing. This is all about bombs. That's all about mutations and frenzy. Okay, well, I think a level up is a pretty good place to end the episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far. And in the next episode, well, I keep saying I'm gonna work my way towards the main quest. I don't know if I'm actually doing that. I'll say it again, I guess. I'm gonna work my way towards the main quest, but am I gonna get to it? Probably not. There's just too much fun to be had along the way. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.